getting away from work, and I said no, that I was a temp and it wouldn't present any problems whatsoever should I get the job. So then he asked me what sort of amp I got, at which point I panicked and said that there was somebody at the door and could I possibly call him back, and that then got into somebody else to find out about amps. Had this potted history of amps. Rang Dave Little back, and the long and short of it was that he arranged for me to be auditioned this coming Monday at 5:15 at Noma Studios in London. So I thought, oh my goodness, what the heck am I going to do now? This joke has gone, like, too far. So the next thing, I read an article in NME. Simon Reynolds was interviewing Paul Weller. And in the article, Paul said a few, one derogatory thing about me. And I thought, ha, this is my chance to get him. Not Simon Reynolds, actually, it was Stuart Cosgrove. He writes the other one, didn't he, Simon Reynolds? But Stuart Cosgrove interviewed Paul Weller. Paul Weller had said this one thing about me, and I thought, ah, this is my chance to get back at him now. I'll continue with the joke. So, with the help of Dave Little, the guy who'd set up the audition, and another guy called Nigel Sweeney, otherwise known as Spanner, we arranged for me to ring Paul Weller tonight to have a word with him about the audition. So, at 6 o'clock, ring Paul Weller. And this is what happened. Hello, Dave.
Hello.
You're right.
Yeah, do you want me to sit down?
Yes, please. What does he know?
Nothing.
But why does he think I'm ringing?
He doesn't.
Right.
No, at all.
So you're just going to say it's going to change on the phone?
Yeah, right.
Okay.
Hold on. Carl! I've got, this old player called Gwyneth Jones on the phone, right? She played with the Yes No people and the Womacks. I think it's worth having a talk to her, over the blower. I'm sure it's worth you having a talk to her anyway about it. Hello?
Hello?
Is that Gwyneth?
Yes, who's that?
It's Paul.
Oh, hello, I didn't expect to speak to you. I've just been talking to, is it Dave? The guy about the audition thing on Monday. And I really don't think I can go through with it. I'm having second thoughts about the whole thing. I mean, especially with, being involved with the, I mean, I don't know that he explained to you, but I'm with the Yes No people.
Right.
And, we've just signed a contract to, London Records. And I think actually, it might be a bit cruel if I sort of, I'm not saying I will get through or anything like that, but you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think that they might think I was doing the dirty.
Right, you're actually part of the band, like?
That's right, yeah.
Oh, it'd be awkward for you, obviously, wouldn't it?
I think so. I mean, I didn't expect things to take off with this band, and I'd been doing a lot of session work and things like that, and I'm really into what they're doing, and I really don't think it would be fair.
Yeah, all right, well, but just
one thing, I'm really sorry to put you to so much trouble, and I read your article in the NME today.
Mm-hmm.
Which I thought was quite interesting. I'm surprised you don't like Janice Long.
Well, I mean, missed her personally, just the fact that she plays. Just not into that sort of style of music, really.
What's wrong with the rubbish that I play?
Oh, it's you, stud.
Well, now, I'll tell you what happened. When you rang in and asked us to do the thing, I thought I'd apply for a joke, you see, but it went too far. And the next thing, that guy rang yesterday and brought me for this audition, and I thought, what the hell do I do? He's asking me about amps and all sorts, and I was coming out with all of this rubbish. And then when I saw this article in the NME, I thought, actually, I can use this to my advantage.
Well, I think some of it, the journalist made it up.
Oh, you liar.
And Mick made some of it up as well, and I begged him not to.
And after all the nice things I say about you.
Yeah, but he didn't have a go at you, really, did I? See how honest I was, Dave? No, I didn't as you. I said it was nothing personal against Janice Long.
At least you're not two-faced. But, now, what is wrong with the music, then? Which night did you listen?
I don't know. They're all them awful indie groups, you know. I can't stand all them.
But you might have been in the same position once yourself.
I know, but why do they want to sound like the Buzzcocks 10 years ago? I mean, it sounded awful first time round.
They all don't. You're just making sweeping statements. Anyway, when's the album coming out?
6th
of February?
Yeah, I think it is, yeah.
Right,
6th of February, anyway.
And the tour follows that?
14th, yeah.
I saw you on the telly this morning, still appealing for girls. I mean, is there still a distinct shortage of female guitarists?
We've got a few more since this morning, but I was talking to someone last night, you know. I think it was Mike who said that there was some, they couldn't do that because of the sexual discrimination thing.
Yeah.
But I heard someone told me last night, that's not true, that you can, unless the BBC have got different rulings or something, different union laws, I don't know. But something that you can actually advertise for.
Well, I know when
positive discrimination, which is for the, you know,
Yeah, but I used to work for a newspaper and we were never ever allowed to mention the sex. You had to just put person.
Aboriginal?
Yeah.
Oh, well.
So, I mean, I don't know. Perhaps it's different rules for different things.
Well, we've got a few more anyway. There's a few more girls, so we're going to audition some next week.
Okay, well, I hope you could get what you want.
I like the Gwyneth.
You might not get it on this show, though. All the best.
All right, see you later.
See you. Bye. And Paul, here is one of those indie bands.